coming up to this stage, as you saw all of you, it's a bit of hurdle. I am going to address this issue today. Before that one, I am going to tell you a short story of myself, an inspirational story. You can think it of as, but I think it's my dream come true. I made my dreams come true from scratch to accessibility consultant. So here we go. This is the name I have given to my presentation, adding means to your aspirations. Everybody has goals, aims, dreams. Am I right or not?
Yes.
So everybody wants to make their dreams come true. So after this session, I think some people will get inspired by me, and they will make their dreams come true. Definitely. Okay? So starting as a kid, I was also a normal kid in my childhood, whereas I was playing with all the children, everybody I was playing with, going to school and doing all the things equally. But somehow or other way, I was contained to wheelchair due to some immobility. The doctors diagnosed that as your age grows, you will be confined to a wheelchair. That was the final decision given by doctors at the age of 11 or 12 for me. So as my age progressed, I got confined to a wheelchair, and I only could complete my intermediate, and I could not continue my degree also. And I was contained to only 4 walls in my house. And I am thinking about this in around 1990s. My parents were also not aware of having accessibility awareness things or anything in those days. So go back. So mentally I think that I am special from others from that day. Next. So from that stage, since 1996, I was an PC operator. I started as a PC operator with the wise advice of a journal uncle. I turned to computers. I learned GDP. I worked for a lot of writers. I have done GDP for their books. And I maintained to graphic designer. Every time I was thinking, what's next? I again contain myself to one technology. So I was a tech savvy at that time itself. So you can assume that in 1998, you can see that there was no internet, proper internet, or we have to access internet through modems. So we don't have accessibility to internet property on that days, and it was only through books I gained knowledge. And the other advantage was, my brother was a computer student at that time. Computer came to our house for him, and it became a career for me at the same simultaneously. He learned all the some things for myself, DKP and desktop publishing. He told me I just learned them and mastered it with my books. So everything was one by one step for me. 15 years I made it to accessibility consultant from a PC operator without any background or without any going to any college. So my role model is Mr. Stephen Hawking, a famous scientist, as you everybody know. Because he says, people don't have time if you are always complaining. You should not complain. You make yourself value. You make your value work. That's what I practiced and I implemented, and I am today speaking here. Next. And after doing all these things, I also had an intent to give back to the society. I shared knowledge to everybody. I had given knowledge to budding entrepreneurs, and I believe sharing knowledge will increase knowledge. And I also trained and groomed many budding designers, craft designers. Okay? Next. So networking and environmental barriers. So I had to do a lot of networking after these technologies have been, because people are not going to come to me in one place. I have to go out to get work. So for this I was doing a lot of networking. Through these fears, I was facing a lot of environmental barriers. So that environmental barriers made me to start Wow Foundation, Wonder on Wheels. So I want to address these issues, accessibility issues, the same thing which I face here. Wherever we go, in public places, we are denied of what we say, a friendly environment. It's only a matter of ordering things they have to provide. But next. They are not going to provide anything. We are denied of everything. We cannot go to a temple, we cannot go to a learning education center, we cannot go to a movie or an entertainment place, we cannot go to a public park. Because they are not friendly for us. And apart from that, people like us, having a lot of aspirations, ideas and dreams, have to constrain ourselves due to these reasons. So I want to lighten up these things, means I want to get awareness, more awareness on these things. I'm fighting for awareness on accessibility issues. These are the major places where we are facing the accessibility issues, and the issues have to be addressed very strongly. Next. I also practice web accessibility and digital inclusion, and I also work on them also, as earlier my friend Srinivas Chakravarti was saying. If they are given equal opportunity, equal access to digital information, they could actively participate towards society, and they can be a part of society, they can part of growth to the society also. Next. These are some origin experiences I have done recently. One is L&T Metro, the Red Metro, and Herbert Metro stations. They have given us an opportunity to test their metro stations and given a chance to audit their places. And I find that it's 100% accessibility friendly. So I think everybody should practice these things in their places, like workplaces or environmental, public places or government buildings, anything. And this is another recent one, the cultural place of a Phoenix office. It is here, sir. These are some programs and events I have launched through few papers. This is an, what we say, initiative called Accessibility Friendly Telangana Hyderabad chapter. It's launched by Gargil, Sir Mr. Gargil, L&T Metro Red. And he has very much appreciated the initiative. I'm working on these things right now. Next. So these are a few things I'm being associated with some organizations. Next. All these things. Next. Next. So this is the this is a big achievement for me recently. There was a poster competition for teen movies of Amitabh Bachchan sir. They have selected my poster, and I was felicitated by Mr. Amitabh Bachchan in Mumbai. They have given me a QR pro flight ticket, and I got this felicitated by Amitabh Bachchan. So from being a TC operator to reaching a big day of the Bollywood Bachchan, it's a dream come true. What do you say?